The first 10 to 15 seconds after exposure to a hazardous substance, especially a corrosive substance, are critical. Delaying treatment, even for a few seconds, may cause serious injury. Eyewash stations provide on-the-spot decontamination. They allow users to flush away hazardous substances that can cause injury. Accidental chemical exposures can still occur, even with good engineering controls and safety precautions. Emergency showers and eyewash stations are a necessary backup to minimize the effects of accidental exposure to chemicals. Your emergency eyewash must be in good working order and must be tested routinely. To help, Risk Management and Safety recommends making every Tuesday test day so that you'll remember to do your weekly test and inspection. Visit the link below or scan the QR code for more on making every Tuesday test day. Here's how to properly test your eyewash station and how to report any issues you may have. Before testing, observe the area surrounding the unit. Make sure the area is free from electrical hazards and any debris, and make sure there is a clear pathway to the unit. Do not block or obstruct the pathway to an eyewash station. If you encounter an obstruction, remove it immediately. Now, before turning on the eyewash station, inspect the eyewash covers and make sure they are in functional order. Check them for their position, cleanliness, and working condition. Lastly, check the sink area and spouts and make sure they are clean and free from trash. Now it's time to test your eyewash. Place a bucket under areas with no plumbing to gather water during flushing. Next, activate the unit by pushing the lever by hand or pushing the foot pedal to determine if the flow is appropriate and constant. The protective eyewash covers should come off when the eyewash is activated, and water should flow from both eyepieces for units with two eyepieces. Now, ensure that flow continues until deactivation. Then, examine if the water drains from the sink. Lastly, document the inspection and performance test by initialing and dating the eyewash tag or an eyewash log near the eyewash. If you encounter an issue, submit a work order with Auburn University Facilities Management. The link to submit a work order is at the bottom of the screen here. Some common issues include water being too hot, water not clearing after several flushes, water appearing discolored, and damage to the unit, such as broken covers or cracks. Eyewashes are one of the most common deficiencies found during lab inspections. We often overlook eyewash stations, even though they are very important to the overall safety of a lab. For more on eyewash safety, visit auburn.edu/RMS.